All right, back into it again here. church here. That's all I'm going to say is the church. I can't give away the story. I forgot the paper clips upstairs to hold that this paper down here I put so I won't smudge my what I've already drawn down there. Normally you stop at the start at the top and work your way down, but that part of the drawing I decided to do first for whatever reason. And like I was saying, starting from the foundation, working your way up is one way you could do it. But I have a mobile. I don't have a drawing desk, so I have a mobile desk that I have to set up every time I come down here to draw. And forgot my paper clips upstairs, which I would use to hold this paper. So it's gonna move on me and it's gonna be fucking irritating. Helped if I put a couple paper clips while on the other side, not here, because of that, to hold this so it doesn't move. But I don't want to go all the way back upstairs. That's where my room is and where all my stuff is. Sometimes I end up making a couple trips because I forgot everything. I have this little kit I got at Target, which I brought down. I might use the triangle on the windows, I'm not sure yet. But like, I'll forget that upstairs and I have to go up and get it. So I can't wait till I get my own place and I can have my a permanent studio, so I don't have to set it up every time. I have everything right there, but you gotta improvise and do what you gotta do, you know. Using a 2H on this, I have a pouch of pencils, which I, pouch of pencils and whatnot from all the way from all the levels of hardness from like 6H all the way to 6B, which is a softness. And honestly, I just randomly pull out a pencil, you know what I mean? But the hard one I'm using here sometimes I like to begin a drawing with a soft pencil, even though it's not light and it might be harder to erase some mistakes. I'll draw light with it and lay anything stuff in because it, you know, I like that that effect of starting with that darker lead. It really doesn't matter what pencil I pick, especially for comic books, because they say lay in with an H and then, or a 2H, and then, you know, put your finishing pencils in with a HB. But I got detail in here, so. The Kubert School that I'm taking here, these correspondence courses say that you can use a hard lead to lay in details and shit. So it's real sharp, real hard. The harder it is, the longer it maintains its sharpness before you have to sharpen it. But apparently it's good for laying in the details. Maybe because it can maintain a sharpness for longer, and it's harder. And yeah, it does produce a finer type of line, so I could see that. Developing a pace that I draw, that I'm able to draw at now. Pretty comfortable with the pace. As long as I want to finish this building in an hour. So I'm just going to work at my steady pace or whatever. I have to go to speed myself up because I might just fuck up. It's when you get toward the end of the drawing, you gotta take more time because you want to get everything precise. So that's not a race. As long as I put the time in and then develop a steady pace. Too hard, too critical on yourself. It steals the joy out of it, So, I'm sure with time I'll get faster, but I'm not going to get hard on myself because I'm not super fast right now, you know what I mean? But when it comes down to it, when it comes to making deadlines, I believe I can deliver, Right now, the Kubert School, it's with this course on penciling that I'm doing, it's supposed to take 6 months. I do two lessons. Just one page. Each lesson is a page of work that you have to do. Two lessons a week, which is 3 to 4 days. Taking 2 days on this one. And that's my first 2 days. So there's other shit. Try to freehand the rest of this as much as I can with another ruler. It's another skill that you can develop to increase speed, is so you don't have to keep picking up the ruler and moving it around. It's to learn how to draw straight lines and shit without a ruler. I imagine it would save you time. And most of the stuff's already laid in, so you can save a lot of it with shading too, and developing the form of it. So that's just not all hard lines. If you try to freehand all hard lines, it might show that, you didn't use it. It might show not to be so precise, but I get there's so many.
Y no hacemos log off, se queda perdido en esa aplicación. Entonces, cualquiera persona que le quiera llamar a usted, va a decir que usted está usando la aplicación con una pinche, un punto, le pone un puntito así, verde, diciendo que usted está el abierto.
¿Un puntito verde es?
Vea.
¿Y cómo lo paga?
Apagando la aplicación.
¿Cómo puede ser un puntito?
Ya, yeah. Eso quiere decir.
Me enseña.
Ajá. El puntito verde quiere decir que usted está usando esa aplicación todavía. Puede decir mi vieja, siempre estoy, como yo, estoy impuesto a nomás colgarle y no hacer nada, porque cada vez que hay un nada, tiene que, para pasarlo otra vez, tiene que login, le tiene que poner su email, su password y todo eso.
Sí,
sí. Vea. Bueno, lo nada, tomando le corto la llamada. Pero entonces cada vez que ella va a hacer una llamada, ve que yo soy el login.
Leonardo da Vinci could draw a perfect circle on a wall without using a compass. Just his hand. It's pretty good. This right here, one solid stroke. Kind of challenging. The lead is a little bit light for this.
No, yo le pagué al chavo de 200 que le dio la reta. Me chequé como 400 ya.
Entonces, ¿por qué no le dio una de datos de reta de una vez?
Porque mi chía paga mi reta.
Pero no sé por qué te conocía después.
No, pues no me va a dar este güey. Este güey te lo chingan los dos. Y no me quiero que reta los tiempo aquí. Este mes tal vez el último mes que me queda aquí.
¿Y vas a ver ahora?
Mi esposa agarró para a mi hermano ya.
Ahora sí, abogado.
Ya. Pero, como estamos peleando todavía y no estoy seguro,
yo debe quedar
los 3-4 meses más aquí, agarrarme para subirte yo solo.
My drones usually come out.
A mí si me corren la verga.
In the end, each stroke I make, they usually come out. Looking okay. So, I'm not worried about it.
Porque ella no quiere pelear su lugar también. Si las cuentas ahorita me están toqueando, va a perder todo. Yo, ¿sabes qué? Lo bueno, gracias a Dios, que yo soy de esos que tengo huevos y no puedo bajar. Pues la última vez la cagué. Ya. La última vez la cagué porque andaba desesperado y.
Ya.
Y llegando al último que llegue, le dije, ¿sabes lo que era? No traigo. Y yo le dije a todo el mundo buscando lo que era. No sé, ya.
Thank you.
better wait, Freddy.
Hi.
Freddy. Hey, Freddy.
Christopher.
You better wait, Freddy.
You're going to be in your room, you're going to be in the living room. Okay. I've got like 5 minutes.
Yeah, and those is the... Okay. Yeah. How many dollars? $25. $25, ¿verdad? Me enojé, la verga. Vuelvo al otro hotel. El gato era un sábado. Era un domingo. Me cobró $150. Pues yo solo. Y yo bien cansado, ya. Yeah. Era un holiday. Entonces le pago los $150. Y yo subo arriba para mi cuarto. Y ahí estoy después.
¡Chavo!
Ahí tiene el parche. Me quedo todo el día. Al otro día, mi vieja no contesta. Fui a comprar comida. Fui a me fui unos toques y me dormí a la verga. En la mañana me levantaron a las 11 y me chequeé el chequeo. Entonces me fui. Y dije, cuánto me quedan 50 bolas. ¿Qué voy a hacer? Cuando yo estaba dentro del puerto, sí, en Cuba me habló, que llegó la contigo y me preguntó. Me dije la verdad, que estaba aquí. Y ahí
dije,
no, tengo 50 bolas. Y yo me dije, no te voy a pagar la renta. Pero la chara te metí que no te lo daría.
Reason why I say keeping a steady pace is because you only have so much time, again, it's a comic book page to get it done. And if you stay at a steady pace, obviously you want to allot yourself a certain amount of time. And then, you know, and you look back, you don't have any regrets over the work, even though some details may be omitted. Like this architecture here, I mucked up a little bit, it's not exactly like picture, but I'm not going to go back and change it. I just don't have the time, but if I keep drawing at a steady pace, I know that I did what I could. I don't have any regrets over it, man.
Buenas noches. You see that other one?
I had a bad day. So what's up with you when you close? Who stole your clothes?
Ruben.
Nah. Yeah, look, bro, he used to get in my shit all the time. And I'm looking for my shit, right? He got it. In my dorm, we shared a dresser, me and him. He was my bunkie. Ruben, that was over here. No, this is what, I'm just going by what they told me at 119, yesterday. I don't know where he was, but it could be they're blaming it on him. I had two fans. And the coach came out of this little fan. Jonathan knows I have fans, right? And I never got my fans.
From here?
From over there. They took all my shit. Bro, I don't even have a body wash. I had 7 body washes on my dresser on the top. I had, look at all the deodorants I had. I got like 2 of them. And they're not even, they're the ones a little old man, and they got me. All my body sprains, all that shit. But look at 3 pairs of pants. This was the only pair of pants I got. Now, I had 3 more pairs, at least 3. 2 Dickies and another black Levi's.
So the Dickies are the blue ones.
Yeah, and I'm fucking out of man. Man, fuck, what can I do?
No, but they got a little more.
Part of the thing with comic book illustration is consistency. You can't produce a stellar, as long as you're consistent and it looks consistently all the way through, you don't have to go fucking bananas on it, I don't think.
If we were just in a regular house, right, and I call them, I'll go over there.
Especially if it's a good story,
Get on like that, man. Look at, bro, I never stole nobody's shit. I mean, I don't get me wrong, I have in the past, but I was in my addiction. I gave money. I come home and I'm
All right. move from one part of the drawing to the next. Completing little parts of it as I go. Eventually it'll reach a finish. It's a good time to be able to part right.
Everything
all right?
Yeah.
Hi. You
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm not gonna let Jonathan know anything about my phone, so you can tomorrow, like next week, we'll still talk about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, stay quiet.
Before he goes home, ask him for it.
Oh, you don't even like that. He gets back. Ooh, you asked me for your phone, I'm gonna keep it for you. He told me. He told me that last time.
Wow, well, come everybody to bug you too much.
Oh, only
if,
have one thing.
If your restriction is not tomorrow, tell your health manager.
I already talked to him. He's saying talk to him.
That's not, don't tell Jonathan nothing.
Yeah.
You're not going to your proper places.
Somebody dropped a quarter. Malfunction.
What did
they
say?
I didn't do anything. Fucking stupid, what's his name? It's crazy, bro. Fucking, he just makes up anything. I'm on the phone with him. He's not even all there.
Oh.
Fucking, He goes, he says everything.
Stupid
Quinn. He's not all there. He's like,
Going to be in the moonlight soon. At the bottom of the drawing, the trees, the moonlight is on the left, so and the trees cast long, deep shadows. So I'm linking the shadows. I'm drawing from a daytime picture of this, and the shadows are shallow shadows. So I'm likening them, and as I'm doing that, I'm seeing that it is giving the effect that it is night, and that it is created by the moonlight. About 21 minutes left. I think I'm gonna get the gargoyles drawn.
Thank you.
Love me, girl. I did too. I went to the ball.
10 minutes left.
Hi, you are currently being recorded.
I'm already taken. By who?
Thank you. Have a blessed night, okay?
guess I know for next time. Should have measured this part. And divided the measurements into 7 windows. The exact measurement. Fucking stupid of me. So I can eyeball when it comes to shit like this, and I never can. Still gonna probably end up alright, but take me far less time if I would have just measured it out exactly. Fuck. This last one was gonna be. So that happens when you try to take shortcuts. Thank you.